हेलो, हाय एवरीवन, आई एम वरद प्रसाद. ओके, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल स्टार्ट लर्निंग लाइक हाउ टू क्रिएट लाइटिंग कंपोनेंट्स, क्रेन, सर्ट कंट्रोल एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स. ओके, नाउ ऑनवर्ड एंड बिफोर वील स्टार्ट. ओके, ऑलरेडी आई हैव अपलोडेड सम लाइटिंग बेसिक वीडियोस लाइक वेयर वी कैन यूज लाइटिंग एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स इन द जस्ट सर्च विथ यूट्यूब, सर्च विथ सेल्स फॉर स्टार्ट चैनल. Then you can find the lightning videos as well as even you can find the interview questions already. These interview questions are nowadays even every interview asking. It will help you in your interviews. Okay, and if you like these videos, just subscribe my channel. And if you have any comments, please provide me in the comment section. Okay. Okay. Now in this video, we'll start like. Salesforce lightning training. From here onwards, we can I will show you like how to create lightning components and applications, client side controller and server side controller styles and all those things. Okay, first of all, what are the benefits of lightning and all those things? Okay, by using lightning applications, these are the benefits available. Okay, we'll create some faster applications using lightning benefits, lightning components and all those things. Okay, fast applications means, for example, in the applications there we can add standard components as well as a custom components. Custom component lightning components means like our requirement, based on our requirement we can create a lightning components, right? Even we can add that components in the application just drag and using lightning app builder. And a rich component ecosystem means like for better UI and all those things, lightning compared to classic Visual Post pages and remaining JavaScript UI. So Lightning provides a better UI and so it's looking compared to like classical, it's look good somewhat, it's look better. And performance wise, why it improves performance means generally in the Salesforce, either in a view of pages anywhere, we need to use a server side controller, right? We will write a normal UI in the view of pages, in remaining controls like everything, buttons and actions, everything we will perform in the controller. So if you want to do any changes, then we need to compulsory, we are doing DML operations in the controller, like a server side controller. So in Lightning, so everything we will do in the client side controller, okay? And just we'll fetch the data using server side controller. We'll do performance, we'll do actions, everything in the client side controller. So that's the reason, like Lightning will. Lightning contains like Lightning applications will respond will respond very faster compared to classic Visual Post pages and all those things because of client side controller. Okay, and event driven architecture. So it is based on events. Everything is controlled by the JavaScript controller, and even these applications will support as like desktop applications, Lightning mobile applications, and tabs and everything. So it will based on the UI. Automatically, Lightning will support for the all the browsers. Okay, these are the benefits of Lightning and all those things. And one more thing is, for example, if you want to work on Lightning in the Salesforce, the first thing we need to do in the Lightning application here is we need to create custom domain. After that, only we can create new components and even we can add those components to the tabs. Even we can create custom Lightning mobile application and all those things. Without custom domain, we can't do anything. Okay, that is the first thing we need to do. And after creating domain, then where we will use these components, Lightning components. Mobile applications will use Lightning pages. Even we can call these applications in Visual Post pages using Lightning out. And even we can create tabs, Lightning tabs. And even we can use communities, build everywhere communities, global actions. And we can call these components in Visual Host pages, Lightning pages, mobile applications, and everywhere. Okay, here we will use the Lightning components. Okay, and even we can add these components in the record detail page everywhere. These are the here we will use the Lightning components. Okay, and see, after creating a custom domain in the Salesforce. Before creating domain, like without domain, our URLs will look like this ap4salesforce.com home and all those things. After creating a custom domain, our URL will look like this, like your custom domain dot my.salesforce.com and home page here. For example, this is in the classic classic pages. once you click on switch to lightning button, so our domains look like this here, lightning.force.com here, here my.salesforce.com. Here we need to observe these two domains after creating a domain and without domain. What is the difference between classic and lightning domains and all those things? This is all about creating domain, okay? And so why we need to create domain and all those things means, so these are the benefits available if you create a domain, okay? So allow users to log in once to external services, and then even if you want to create single tenant applications, we need to create domain, okay? And if you want to create lightning components, tabs, lightning pages, domain is mandatory. Without that, even lightning applications will not visible in the Salesforce org. Okay, so that's the reason lightning domain is mandatory, and even we can brand our like a domain and all those things. Okay, so this is all about domain in the Salesforce, my domains. After creating domain, then we'll create the lightning applications and all those things, no problem. Okay, so I will start creating components and all those things now onwards. So for example, if you want to create all those things already in my org, already I have created domain. Okay, I will show you how, where is domain and all those things. Just in the setup search with the domain or my domain. So already I have created, this is my domain name. You can observe here, lightning. This is the my domain name. See here, you can observe domain name. This is activated. Once you created the domain, it will take like 10 to 15 minutes to activate your domain. After activation, after once our domain is activated, then we can create lightning applications. We'll use all those things. Okay. So already in my org, already domain is there. So what just we discussed, right? Say same thing is available here. Our domain is available here. Lightning Vara, and till here I have given my domain name. This is common for all the remaining applications, lightning.force.com. okay, so if you want to create lightning application like components and all, directly we'll create those components in the developer console only. Okay, just copy. Okay, so I will add this that URL here, so that it will look easily for me to do anything. Okay, after adding okay, once we open this, so here in the file, here only we can create, right, new classes, triggers, video force pages and components, static resource. So here onwards we'll create the lightning related components. So first we'll create lightning component. We can use, see, we'll call it as first lightning component. Okay, just I'm giving same description here, and this is a bundle with the following configurations. So based on this only we'll identify where we'll use this lightning component. As if you want to use this component in the lightning tab, you need to check this checkbox. If you want to use this component in the lightning page, you need to enable this checkbox. So now we will I will enable all these checkboxes, so later I will explain you each one in this bundle. Okay, just enable all those checkboxes, just click on submit button. Okay, so just remember one thing, whenever you create a lightning component and any even OPS class or triggers anywhere, just give a small information about that classes or components, so that it will easily helpful for other people even they don't know about this all those things. Just I'm giving just small component name here. So next, so instead of, so even like lightning will is a case sensitive, we need to provide exact names. Otherwise, if you are specific, instead of small capital letter F, if you use a small F, even your lightning component will not work. So that's the reason if you give component details and everything in the page itself, so that it is directly you can use this name in the applications everywhere, wherever you want. Okay, once you created open the lightning component here, you can observe here, this is the lightning component bundle. So here component controller, this is the client side controller, this is helper will call in the controller, and the styles documentation, all these are available. We'll see one by one in the going forward. Okay, now first we'll see how we'll create variables and how we can use all those things. So this is our Lightning component. See, if we here we can observe Aura component implements force app hostable. This means this, if you specify this force colon app hostable, we will use this Lightning component in a like a Lightning tab. If you specify flexi page colon available for all the page types, you can use this in the Lightning app builder. There you can drag and drop this page and you can use it. If you specify available for record home, so you can use this in the record detail page and Lightning app builder also. If you specify force colon as record ID, this means, so if you are using this component in any record detail page, so automatically we'll get the record ID from the URL if you specify force colon as record ID. So just now I'm explaining just brief information about these components. Going forward, we'll explain. I will explain clearly in depth of this implementations and all those things. So using force community available for all page steps, we can use community. This is global actions, quick actions. We can use this one. So if you specify access equal global, we can access this component even inside Salesforce and outside Salesforce. So this is all about our component. See, for example, if you are in the class, if you want to declare variables, how we can declare? So for example, I want to declare some string. So in the class we can give like this only, right? String name. So Prasad. So for example, this is the data type string. So name is a reference variable. I am assigning where Prasad is name to the this name variable. If I want to print that variable, then what we will do? System.debug. Okay. So in the system.debug, just will print this data, whatever the data is there available in the Lightning name. Okay, same thing. For example, if you want to create variables in the Lightning, we need to use R attribute tag. Using R attribute tag, we can create variables and we can assign some data, even default data, and even we can assign some data from the client side controller and all those things. Okay, for example, if we'll perform same thing in the Lightning, so that we can understand how we can define variables and all those. So just type R attributes. Using R attributes, we can create the variables. Okay, so for example, if you want to create string, so there I will give attribute name equal to, I will give employee name. Okay, R attribute name equal to employee name, and type equal to string. And if you want to assign some default value, you can assign. Otherwise, even we can assign some data from the client side controller also. Now we will give some default value here. Varaprasad. Okay. Just click on save. If any errors is there, it will throw errors like syntax errors. Any even these attributes are not available in this tag. So it will throw error like this is not undefined or not available in this component like this. It will throw error. So here you can observe this is a type string. So this is similar like a string data type. Okay, and here we are giving variable reference variable employee name. So this is similar like a name. So here we are setting some default value similar to the here. We are assigning some data to the name. So both are same. So now if you want to print this data in Apache class, we will use system.debug. So if you want to refer this data in Lightning component, we will use the expressions. Okay. We'll use the expressions. Okay. Lightning expression. So if you want to refer the like the expression, how we will give means, I will provide you some sample syntax also here. So we need to give a just v dot attribute name. So exclamator v dot attribute name, so that we will refer the data type from the components. So now whatever the data is there in these attributes, the data is available from the in the expression. For example, now I want to print the employee name. So I will directly give employee name equal to. So we need to write expression like this. V means it will refer to the variables in the lightning component. So just V dot variable name. What is the variable name? Employee name. So that's all. Like this, we can refer the attributes from the lightning component. Okay. Here, this is the data type variable data. That's it. If you want to use this, if you want to print this data, directly we can use expression like this syntax. A variable refers to the v dot attribute name. V means in this component, whatever the components available, that is variable, like variable dot which attribute you want to refer, attribute name. So this is available now. So if you want to check now this employee name is like this data is printing or not, so we'll check in multiple ways. We can add this component in Lightning app builder, or for example, now we will create some Lightning sample application. There we can see how the data is displaying and all those things. So for that, I will create Lightning application. So just I will rename this component name. Instead of Lightning component, I will give first Lightning app here. Just click here. So if you use this checkbox, then you can use this application in the VFS pages. We can call this application VFS pages. So now I am enabling this checkbox. Even if you don't want, just remove. Later we can discuss this one. Lightning out dependency app. Just click on submit button. So this sharing first name is already defined. Please choose a different name. So we'll give another name here. Lightning application. So I will give same description. Just click on submit button. So here also you can follow some better best practices here. Just define your application name, app name equal to, okay, so that it will easily identify this is the first Lightning application and all those things. Okay. For example, if you want to call these components from Lightning components to the Lightning applications, we need to use our org namespace. By default, all orgs are having C as a namespace. Then C dot component name. Just copy, just paste here, and just save here. Okay. Just click on save button. Just here you can observe here preview is available. Just click on preview button so that we can identify here employee name Varapra Sadi is available here. You can observe here this UI is not a Lightning UI. If you want to show Lightning statistics and all those things in the preview, like in the Lightning components, if you want to convert that component to the Lightning styles, we can use keyword is available. Just remember, in previously we are using Lightning DGN system. We are loading that DGN system in static, uploading in a static resource, and there then we are using that styles and all those things. Now recently, just we are using extends keyword. Using extends keywords, automatically whatever the Lightning by default styles available, we can use those things. So just we need to specify force colon SLDS. So then automatically Lightning the component, whatever the component is there, that component completely moves to the Lightning styles. Just now click on update preview button before, just see, you can hear, observe here already. So now our page is converted to the Lightning UI. Previously that is not contains Lightning styles and all those things. Now this page moves to the Lightning employee name and all those things. Okay. And One more thing is, if you want to add some styles and all those things to the whatever is available in the Lightning, if you want to create, add chords and all those things, so just so you can see here components. I will show you like. So just use this URL. Using this URL, we can add some what we can check like whatever the Lightning tags available and all those things. Along with we can check whatever we created till now components. All those are available here. Just this is common URL https://lightning.force.com/component-library/overview-components. Just here we need to change our domain name. Okay. So in the component library we can see all the components buttons, which tags are available and all those things. See, these are the Lightning using this Lightning component. What are the buttons? See, for example, you want to create some buttons with styles. Just click on button. So here you can see some sample code available here. So with the styles based on each button is having some different colors and all those things, right? So like this Lightning comp box. So like this. This is the pick list. So like this, even you have Lightning components available and Aura components, Force components, whatever is there, all are available. Here you can see these are the components I have created. Even you can check with your components also here, whatever is there, all those things. Okay, just remember this URL. So here you can observe all the remember this. You just add https://, here your domain name .lightning.force.com, then your component library and all those things, so that all the components, whatever is there available in Lightning, along with your components or components, all are available here. You can add even styles and all those things. For example, if you want to add a Lightning chord or other things, so if you want to use like some Lightning chord like this, you can use Lightning chord also. Just you can add this one, so automatically the chord is available. For example, I will add and I will show you how this is available, chord and all those things. Just I will add this Lightning chord here, so that chord is available. So just click on save button. Now refresh this page. You can observe chord is available here now. Correct. So like this, we can use all those things, Lightning chord, footer, and all those things. If you want, don't want these other things, can remove. And even if you want, whatever, if you want custom names and all those things, you can use it. Just refresh it. Think page is not saved. Lightning chord title is mandatory attribute in the Lightning chord, so that's the reason it is showing a error. Title equal to employee details. I will give some employee details. So just refresh this page. Now cart will open. See, this is a cart title, employee name. So like this, you can use based on our requirement, we can use all those buttons. Okay, and even like files upload, how we can use syntax file upload, Lightning input type. See, this is a syntax. So we can check all the based on our requirement, we can use all those things, input type. Like on how we will use a like Apex Lightning input field like that. So we can use all data types here, all the data types available, search input, URL and all those things. So it will help us. Even if you here you can observe here even like a sample data, sample code also available. So based on our requirement we can convert this. So this is all about Lightning component reference guide. Yeah, like how we can. So this is our first Lightning component. So if you want to call this Lightning component, just remember this point. If you want to call this Lightning component, we'll use the arg namespace C and purpose component, Lightning component name. And if you want to apply styles, Lightning application styles, just remember this keyword, extend equals to force:STLS. Using this keyword, we can apply the Lightning styles for the our Lightning component. Okay. For example, I want to print employee name, like first name, last name, and middle name. So we'll give like this employee first name. I will give first name Para. So I will create three attributes then. employee first name and middle name, last name, all are strings only. So I will change this default values here. Or press search. So Vemula. Okay. So if you want to refer these attributes, then same syntax, whatever we are using here. Employee name. Just remove this code. Just give some space, then give another attribute. So here first we'll give first name, last name, then first name, middle name, then we can give last name. So I'm giving first name here. Just copy this expression and give employee middle name. Sorry, copy this one. Give employee middle name, then give last name. Okay, so employee last name. So I will give employee last name here. Just click on save button. So just click on save button. Either you can go on application, just click on update preview button. Otherwise, even you can just refresh the page. So it will display the recent code, whatever you changed, all those things. Okay. So already whatever that is being, all this that is coming here. So just we need to change something. So instead of that, we can specify all the components in single place so that we cannot have any issues. So I will remove all this code. Okay, employee first name. So like this I'll give v dot employee first name and we dot employee last name. So I will copy this name and I will use here. Then I will add some space between these two names. Okay, I will add KK employee last name here. Okay. I will close this bracket. Employee first name and I will copy middle name and I will add here. Employee last name copy, add here. So here we will remove spaces. Here we can give some small spaces. Okay. Just click on save button. Just click on update preview or you can refresh this page also. So now you can observe here. Para Prasad Vemula. So like this we can give expression syntax like this. So that whatever the data is available, so that will refer the data. Even this is string, even if you want to refer integer also, you can give, like you can add integers also. For example, I want to add some age, employee age. So I will add attribute, new attribute or attribute. I will give a name like employee age. Okay. And I will make it integer. So I will give some default value 24. Just to save the page. So if you want to print that employee age, so I'm giving here employee h equal to, okay, just refer the v dot attribute name employee h. Just click the save button. Okay, just we use some break statement so that both will divide. Save button. Now just refresh this page, you can see employee name and the age also available. So like this you can add some more boolean value if you want to add. Just copy this attribute, type our attribute like name equal to gender, either for example if you want to check gender, type equal to boolean. and the default value equal to true. Otherwise, you can employ just give male instead of gender. Male true means is a male, otherwise female. Just save. And if you want to refer this attribute, you can copy just employ is male. So I will copy this variable name and I will give some break statement here. Okay, just save, refresh this page. So you can employ is male true. Like this, we can add all the data types. You can use like a long decimal, and even we can use the S objects and all those things. Going forward, we'll see. So this is all about data types how we can use in Apex class, like string name. Same like this only, we also we can use like string and all those things. Okay. This is all about in this video. So if you like my video, please subscribe my channel. Okay, and next week we will discuss like our if statements and some more iterator components and all those things. Okay, thanks guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel so that you will get recent videos whatever I am uploading, so that you can receive email notifications. Thanks guys, bye.